All right, we're back with, of course, more Taylor. Because I mean, could we ever react to enough Taylor? The answer is no, obviously. The fuck, trick fucking question. There's never enough Taylor. So, like, literally, I could react to every song from her, and it's never enough Taylor. I could do just a whole second round of reactions. You know what I'm saying? It's never enough Taylor reactions. So, yeah, shout out to, I do not want to pronounce your name wrong, but Linnea, it looked like Linnea Thunberg. I could be totally pronouncing that wrong. If I'm pronouncing it wrong, sorry. I'm a fucking asshole. As you can tell from most of these videos anyway, so. But she asked if I had, heard the 3 a.m. edition, the 3 a.m. tracks, and, which I totally have heard them, but I didn't even think to react to them. I don't know why. You know, when I reacted to Midnights in the other video, that I have a Midnights reaction. I don't know. So when this album first came out, cause right, this one came out like right. The 3 a.m. condition, 3 a.m. edition came out like right after the regular edition. But so I hadn't heard the regular edition enough. So I didn't hear this one until like maybe a week, probably about a week later. And so when I did the reaction to the other one, I was like, I just want to hear just the album, the regular album. And then, so I don't know. But yeah, great. Thank you for the suggestion is the point. Shout out to you. Big shout out to you. Thank you for watching. And big shout out to you for the idea. So yeah, we're going to do the 3 a.m. edition. Or the 3 a.m. tracks. I'm not going to hear the whole thing. Just the 3 a.m. Just the 3 a.m. tracks. I mean, what is there to say about them? There's a lot. And in all my videos, I do a lot of rambling in my videos too beforehand. Because normally, first of all, I just have so much stuff on my mind that I want to say about all these, whatever the hell it is I'm reacting to. But also, because like, since I'm not trying to be a YouTuber, I'm not trying to be a reactor, I don't have to pause the music every 2 seconds for copyright, so I don't get copyright strike, so my video could get monetized. You know what I'm saying? I don't care. I don't care. I'm just listening to these. So, yeah. So I do a lot of talking beforehand because I don't really like to pause while I'm listening because I don't. There's a lot of. I said this in some other videos. Shout out. There's a lot of real dope reactors out there, like reaction channels. But if you're hearing from something for the first time and you're pausing it every 15 seconds. On a 3 minute song and you're talking for 5 minutes in between, like, you're not really hearing it really for the first time. You know what I mean? Like, cause you're not even hearing, you haven't even heard it for the first time. You heard the first 15 seconds, then you heard another 20 seconds, then you heard, you know what I mean? So I don't, and even though this is not my first time, so I could pause it to talk, but who gives a fuck? Listen, when I'm always smoking anyway, so you know I'm gonna be smoking while we hear this, so nah. So I'm just gonna talk a little bit before that. To say that, yeah, these tracks. All right, I gotta go track by track. We gotta do a track by track. The Great War, I mean, see, the thing about these tracks is that it's like they don't, like, you see where they would have sort of kind of maybe fit, but they don't. But there's still good tracks. So like, The Great War, great fucking song. Are you serious? Like, come on. Like, the lyrics insane, right? But the bridge is super fire, right? Insane, right? Like, and you know me, like I said it on other videos, but I love it. For me, I care about lyrics and I love lyrics, but I'm more biased towards melody than lyrics. Always, always, always. Maybe it's just, I don't know, maybe it's why I'm so into jazz, but like, I love lyrics though, of course. I do love lyrics, but I am slightly more biased to melody. And just the melody on that. Like, if you notice the video, you'll always see me doing this. Cause like, it's always about the melody, like the way the melody bounces and how is. You know? know what I mean? The lyrics are great too, but I'm saying just as a melody itself. You know what I'm saying? If somebody just played that instrumental, that melody, dun, 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 you know what I mean? Fire. But it doesn't feel like, I don't know, like hearing it, I'm like, yeah, I see why this was not on the album. Like, I could see where it doesn't really, motherfuck, am I not even fucking, you know, it's hilarious. And I'm going to leave this in the video because it's a real, just to make this shit real. So earlier I was doing I was on a fucking Google Meet and I was using this mic. So I'm plugged into a different interface. My dumbass is talking into this, holding it, and I'm looking at my interface over here, and I'm like, why is there no signal? What the fuck? Oh, my dumbass didn't even plug it in. But you know what? We gotta keep it in. You know what? Because this shit's real. What am I fucking, a YouTuber? What am I, a YouTuber over here? All right. Now that was just basic fucking. All right, there we go. There. Is the audio better now? Motherfucker. Damn. All right. That fucking high already. Fuck. Anyway. So, yeah. I don't feel that track really fit in with what it fit on the album as much as, you know, the rest of the album. You know what I mean? Bigger Than the Whole Sky? I mean, I don't know. Could that be... I don't know. Everyone has what's their saddest Taylor song. That's up there. For me, that's up there. I mean, that chorus is so... And then the melody, though. Like... Especially, I don't know, if you have, like, maybe you have, like, fucking shit with, like, people leaving, and you hate saying goodbyes. A song where the chorus is literally goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Damn, what the fuck? What the fuck, Taylor? Really, Taylor? Really? You had to do us like that? Like, really? Really? Damn. So, like, but even that one, I feel like, yeah, I don't know. I feel like Midnight's is just perfect the way it is. Like, none of these... Well, when we get there, everybody already knows which one. When we get there, that one, I don't know how it wasn't on there. Paris, I like Paris. I mean, it's a good track. You know what I mean? I see why it wasn't on there. But I felt like that one also sort of felt like it could have been on there. Because it's... I love Question. But Question, Bejeweled, and Paris all have the same kind of vibe, if you know what I'm saying. So, like, Paris, I felt like it sort of could have been on there, but also not, though. So I get why it wasn't, though. But I feel like it's sort of, kind of, more than the last two, you know what I mean? High Infidelity, I mean, I mean, did she really write a song about fucking, like, did she really? Like, did she really write a song about that? Like, it's kind of... But it's a thing where it's like, you kind of gotta, I don't know, because it's from the point of view of that, though, you know, like, I don't know, like, do you really want to know, like, geez, but then, oh my god, like, that's, I don't know, it's kind of, how he brought me, do you want to know how he brought me back to life is brutal, like, I get, but like, it's almost like that's just kind of brutal, but dope, real dope song though. Another one though that I just feel like, okay, but I love all of these though. It's in the same way that if fucking Look What You Made Me Do didn't make it on Reputation for some reason, whatever, even though it's really about the whole situation, but and somehow this was like a bonus track, I'd be like, hey, it's a great song, but it doesn't fit. You know what I'm saying? But it's a great song. I don't hate the song. You know what I'm saying? But so these are all, I love all these songs, but I feel like the 3 a.m. tracks are their own thing. You know what I mean? It's as opposed to a different version of the album. As opposed to an extension of the album, to me, they're just a separate thing. I'll just say that. Glitch. I absolutely, not only do I love melody, but anything in falsetto, I mean, come on. I go crazy for anything in I can't even do it. I can't go up that high. And the oh my god, come on, man. And then obviously, I mean, what if, could have, should have, like, what is there to even say about that? Like, everybody knows, like, it's literally one of her best, it's just, it's one of her best songs, like, ever, which is crazy because she has so many fucking amazing songs. That is, I mean, the song is amazing, the record is amazing, the productions, everything is so great. Such a great fucking track. The melody is so amazing, the vocal performance, everything is so good, so good, so good. I will say, I don't personally relate. I know the everyone went crazy, give me back my girlhood, it was my first. Maybe as a guy, I just don't relate to that. But I still love the song, though. So maybe I can't really, really, truly appreciate that song. In the same way, you know, some people might not truly be able to appreciate Ludacris' Area Codes. I got hoes in different area codes, right? Like, you might not relate to that. You might not got a bunch of hoes in different area codes. You know what I'm saying? I don't necessarily relate to giving back my girlhood. It was my first, but I feel it though, but I don't feel it at that level, I guess. You know what I'm saying? But amazing. I mean, it's like, it should have been on the record. Like, I sort of get why it wasn't, but I kind of don't. And the album is what, 48 minutes or some shit? It's not even 50 minutes. So I was like, could have been on. I don't know. I think it's crazy that it wasn't on there. To me, that track is like New Romantics. It's one of her best songs. And it's crazy that it was not on the album because it fits so perfect. How is New Romantics not on there? Like, I don't know. After you've heard it so many times, after you've heard Midnight so many times, it's like, okay, it's almost kind of like, where would you put it? But it still should have been on there. You know what I mean? New Romantics, like, it's, I don't know. It's just, it should have been on 1989. This should have been on here, I think. I don't know. And then Dear Reader, I mean, to me, Dear Reader is definitely, like, out of all of these, I don't want to say out of all of them. They're all amazing lyrically, but I really like the lyrics on Dear Reader. The, like, the way that it was written. Like, the, you know what I mean? Like the, how do you even fucking say it, man? Like, just the fucking way that she took it in terms of, like, addressing, you know, somebody who's reading the lyrics, Dear Reader. Like, I super fire. And, let's just get into this. I'm sure I'm gonna fucking be going crazy. I'm gonna fucking look like a fucking asshole. Getting super fucking high to Taylor. But it's Taylor. It's fucking Taylor, man. Man, 1.3 million people in the line for the pre-sale today for Brazil. Crazy. They have to add another date. There's no way. How do you have three dates for that whole country? They have to add another one, I'm assuming. They added another date for Argentina. They have to add another one for, they have to add at least probably a second night in Rio, right? They have to do a second night in Rio. But super fire, super fire. Super excited to hear this, even though I've heard this so many times. But who gives a shit? I'm gonna get high listening to Taylor. How could you not be excited? What the fuck? If you're not excited to get high and listen to Taylor, get the fuck off this channel. Get the fuck out of here. We don't want you around. You're not welcome now. You can chill. If you're not excited, just chill and listen anyway. By the end of it, you'll be hyped. By the end of it, you're gonna be like, oh, I get it. Mm-hmm. I think a lot of people, I don't know, because I know so many people hate on Taylor who never even heard her, or maybe heard like a song or two, and they just hate whatever is the perception that they have of her in their mind from like a media image. You know what I mean? With so many people are like that, with so many, whatever, but so many people, well, I'll talk about music, like, talk about music, for example, but it's like, I think there's so many people who would, like, if they would just hear these songs and it wasn't in their mind, it's almost like, it's like, you know, fucking, like with food, there's a lot of foods that people won't want to try because if they know what it is, but if they were to just taste it, it's delicious. You know what I mean? And it's like, if someone was to hear something, like, oh, that's great, who is it, Taylor Swift? Oh, I don't like it then. Like, what? Like, people are fucking, I don't know. Let's get into this. Let's get into this shit. What am I rambling about? Let's get high. Let's fucking, all right. If you're smoking with me, let's smoke. Let's do it. I'll try not to ramble too much, but, like, during this music, but can't promise anything. Neighbors. This video is called Fuck the Neighbors. You drew up some good faith treaties. I drew curtains closed, drank my poison all along. You said I have to trust more freely. But diesel is desire. You were playing with fire. And maybe it's the past that's talking.
Just write that though.
do that?
Cause it's all over now. All out to see.
That makes you want to stop songwriting, because how the fuck am I even gonna write something like that? You know what I mean? What the fuck? What the fuck, Taylor? Why are you doing this to us, Taylor? Why would you do this to us? Why? Why?
Fucking serious, like, why would Taylor do that to us? Really though? Really though? Yeah, see, give me something like this, Taylor. I'm trying to come on, Taylor. You don't gotta crush my soul like that. Give me something like Paris. Is that, you know what I mean? There, much better. That's what we need. Light it up, Taylor.
Sister, met someone at a club and he kissed her. Turns out it was that guy you hooked up with ages ago. Some wannabe Z-lister. And all the outfits were terrible. 2003, unbearable. Did you see the photos? No, I didn't, but thanks though. I'm so in love that I might stop breathing.
That's what we need, Taylor, come on.
No, I didn't see the news. Cause we were somewhere else. Don't put down, pretend
the melody's amazing.
It's champagne. I was taken by the view, like we were in Paris, like we were somewhere else.
That's the way she's a laser with the.
Like we were in Paris.
Like yo,
we were somewhere else.
Come on.
Privacy sign on the door and on my page and on the whole world. Romance is not that. If you keep it just yours,
like,
never date above all the messes made. Sit quiet by my side in the shade, and not the kind that's thrown. I mean the kind underwear a tree has grown. I'm so in love that I might stop breathing. Drew a map on your bedroom ceiling. No, I didn't see the news, cause we were somewhere else. Stumbled down pretend alleyways. You want make believe it's champagne. I was taken by the view, like we were in Paris.
Like,
where else?
should have been on the album, right? This one totally could have been on the album.
I want to brainwash you and love me forever.
I get too hyped when I listen to Taylor. I don't give a fuck. I get hyped. Paris. Yes, we were somewhere else. My love, we were in Paris. Yes, we were somewhere else.
I mean, come on, like. I know I just say that after every track, like, come on, but I mean, come on, like, you know, like, what else even, like, what does he even say, like, it's so fire. If this had been a fucking his own album, or it's like his own, just, like, little EP, you know what I mean? This would be amazing. It is amazing, you know what I'm saying?
Log broken, slur spoken, wound open, game token, I didn't know you were keeping count.
I didn't want to say anything,
Rain soaking, blind hoping, you said I was freeloading, I didn't know you were keeping count.
I I have to pause. I'm not pausing in the middle of the song, so I didn't want to do that. And I didn't want to talk in the middle of it, but I don't mean to pause, but like, I come on. Like, I have the same reaction for every fucking song. Like, come on. Lisa Simpson, like, you know, whatever. But I'm saying though, like, like, you know. I really do. Some chick told me that recently. She goes, "You talk like fucking like totally LA, like Lisa Simpson." Like, you know, whatever. Nah, but like, I don't give a shit. That's how I talk. Whatever. whatever. Like, you know, whatever. Just that song, like that she wrote that song, like the lyrics. Insane, man. The melodies, like the production is great. Also, that at the very end, am I the only one getting like postal service vibes from that, right? Like totally, like. But if you guys never heard postal, go listen to the postal service. They only have one album. It's amazing. Go listen to it. But like that song in particular, I mean, all of them. I could have kept pausing after everyone realistically, but just on that one, like, I don't know, just certain, you know what I mean? Certain thing. I don't know. That one is insane. But lyrically, that one's super. They're all insane, but you know what I mean?
We were supposed to be just friends. You don't live in the part of town, but maybe I'll see you out some weekend. Depending on what kind of mood and situationship I'm in, and what's in my system. I think there's been a glitch. 5 seconds later, I'm fastening myself to you with a stitch. And I'm not even sorry, this is so sorry. Blood moonlit, it must be counterfeit. I think there's been a glitch.
Come on, are you serious? The melody is insane. To sweat you out. The lyrics, I love the lyrics too much.
In search of glories, happenings of happenstance on someone else's playground. But it's been 2,190 days of our love blackout.
But listen to the production on the drums.
I think there's been a glitch.
Obviously the vocal production, of course.
Interruption, a slight malfunction, I'd go back to wanting dudes who give nothing. I thought we had no chance, and that's romance. Let's dance.
Yeah.
blushed than they could have. Never whispered about this. And if you never saved me from boredom,
I'm peeking.
I was, but Lord, you made me feel important.
Not on drugs, I mean.
And then you tried to erase us. You're a crisis of my faith. What a good show. If I'd only played it safe, I would have stayed on my knees. In redemption, never would have danced with the devil. At 19, and the God's honest truth is that the pain was heaven. Now that I'm grown, I'm still a ghost. Memories feel like weapons. And all that I know, I wish you left me wondering.
These things cranked right now.
Oh, my neighbor's gonna hate me right now.
Falling apart. Never.
take advice from someone who's falling apart. So I wander through these nights. I prefer hiding in plain sight. My force drink in my hand. These desperate prayers of a cursed man spilling out to you for free. But darling, darling, please, you wouldn't take my word for it if you knew who was talking. If you knew where I was walking to a house, not a home, alone, cause nobody's here. Where I'm pacing my pen and my friends, no friends who care. No one sees when you lose, when you play in solitaire.
I can't with that. Are you serious? You know, there's some songs that you gotta sing along, and there's some songs you just gotta shut the fuck up and just fucking. No, autoplay. No, although this, I love that song. Actually, I'm gonna do Lover. I'm gonna react to Lover next. I'm gonna do it next. I was supposed to do the Anita marathon. No. Hold on. I'm gonna do the Anita marathon first. Then I'll do Lover. We gotta do the Anita marathon. But man, you know, sometimes you just gotta shut the fuck up for it. You kind of just shut up and just listen. That's it. Like. You could sing or anything, whatever, but no, some songs just shut the fuck up. Just shut up. And right there, like, oh my gosh, shut up. Like, it was too much, you know? That was too much. Like I said, I think if she would have just put it out as a second, as like a separate EP called 3 AM, like a companion EP. Ooh, that's a fire idea. Ooh, that's a fire idea, right? Has anyone done that? All right, remind me to do that, guys. Make an album and then a companion EP to that album. That's essentially what that is, though. But not really, because again, it's kind of tracks that didn't make it. I guess just release it. But if she would just all those tracks together, I mean, that was so good. Like, that was so fucking good. They're all so fucking good. There wasn't one of those tracks that you go, eh, eh. Like, they're all... You know, so I understand why everybody loves the 3 AM edition and listens to it all the way through. But to me, I kind of hear them as two separate things. But fucking so good. Oh my God, so. That's right, I have a mic. Here we go. Wait, are we in my end? Yeah, all right. I gotta make sure I'm plugged in after I fucked up in the beginning. All right, yeah, I mean, what else is there to say? I mean, it's Taylor Swift. It's Taylor fucking Swift. You know what I'm saying? Like, what do you say? What do you say? I think, realistically, I don't know, it's hard to, I don't know. I think off the top of my head, the two, like, in terms of music, like, the two artists that are, I think they're, like, the best and most influential from this century have to be fucking, it has to be her and Kanye, right? I know they got the thing, but, like, it has to be, right? Like, who's more influential than, like, the two of them? I don't know. You could argue some names, maybe, but I don't know. I can't think of a couple names that you could really put up there. Maybe for the past 23 years, right? Just this century so far. Who else would you put up there? You can't really. Who else is more influential than those two? Like, Taylor's so good. Like, Taylor's. It's Taylor. Like, no shit, all right? No shit with Taylor's gay, of course. Like. And I don't know if anybody's watching and they're Swift, they started booing me right now when I fucking said about Kanye. Boo! I know. I don't know either of them personally. I'm just talking about in terms of music and in terms of their influence. Like,
Who else? Who else could you even say? I can't think of anyone else. I can think of a few names maybe, but I don't know. But, man, so good. So good. So my point is like, yeah, no shit. If I say, oh, it's so good. Like, yeah, no shit, it's good. It's Taylor Swift. It's like one of the fucking best artists of the century. Arguably number one, right? So what else did I say? We'll come back with some more Taylor reactions, I guess. You know what I gotta react to? Next I'm gonna react to is, I love is that, that performance that she did of Red at the CMAs with, like, Edgar Meyer and Sam Bush and fucking, Vince Gill and Alison Krauss. Woo! That shit was fire. We gotta react to that one. That was really dope. Alright, we're gonna come back with that one. Anyway, and I'm gonna go, we got the Needham Marathon, and then we're gonna come back, I'm gonna react to Lover, Reputation, do Folklore, gonna do Evermore. I don't know, I got a lot of stuff, so if you happen to be subbed and watching this, shout out to you guys. And yeah, we'll be back with some more.